In a story you saw first on KXOY4, a Ferris High School vice principal accused of molesting a teenage boy. Well, that assistant principal at Ferris High School is on administrative leave tonight after he became the focus of a police investigation on sex crimes investigation. Spokane School District officials suspending Todd Bender late Tuesday afternoon, just hours after they heard the allegations against the veteran educator. In a story you saw first on KXOY4, crime reporter Jeff Humphrey joins us now live at Spokane Superior Court. And Jeff, Bender's been accused of molesting a family friend.
Nadine, this is a young man who kept this alleged sexual abuse a secret for years. He says the only reason that he's coming forward now is he learned that Mr. Bender was trying to contact another young boy using the same sneaky approach.
Organizing 2,000 kids to get off of our campus and get prepared to move down to the Spokane Arena.
Among other things, Assistant Principal Todd Bender was in charge of campus security at Ferris High School. In previous news stories, Bender appeared committed to keeping our kids safe. But now an 18-year-old family friend is accusing Bender of molesting him when the teen was 14 and 15 years old. The first incident allegedly happened in 2011 inside Bender's Indian Trail area home. Police say Bender gave the victim beer and offered to let him spend the night so his parents wouldn't know that he'd been drinking alcohol. The then 14-year-old says he was awakened by Bender's hands on his private parts. The alleged victim says similar incidents happened at Merkle Sports Complex and Diamond Lake. The morning after Bender was suspended from his job here at Ferris, someone called 911 to Bender's residence for a medical emergency. Bender told paramedics that he'd been sick for several days and was taken to a local hospital. And tonight, Mr. Bender is still hospitalized and unable to leave that facility. Nadine, Spokane police say when he is discharged, they plan to arrest him.
Oh, Jeff, we understand that sex crimes detectives now are using a warrant to search his phone.
And that's because long after this alleged molestation had ended, Mr. Bender continued to call and text the victim. The latest message coming in just back on October 17th. Nadine, we should also let you know that KXY4 sources are telling us that Mr. Bender has made a full confession to these incidents. Reporting live at Spokane Superior Court, Jeff Humphrey, KXY4.
All right, thank you, Jeff. And we'll continue to gather more details on this story as they become available. We'll keep you updated on KXOY.com and on social media, as well as the radio with our partners at News Radio 920.